It's Bill from CNN Precision Spindle. This is a quick little tip on dialing in the back of the spindle shaft. You don't run into it very often, but it's one of those things I explain to you guys a lot of time on the phone. So to shortcut that, I'm going to show you how I do it. Problem is, we have a Matsuura spindle here. This thing goes 20,000 RPM. It's running out back here. It was running out a thou and 3/10. I've already started, but I want to get this on video so it helps people. With the run out back here being unacceptable, I want to see 2/10 or less, preferably 1. Thou and a half is a no-go. Everything was fine until I put the spacer on and the nut. Now the spacer has set screws that are located in place. And that's actually a ring with balancing holes for balancing the vents. Okay. This one is your standard KTM 12. So KTM 12 nut. This one's made by SKF. They're really nice, but they are still a nut on a thread, which is a helical plane. A helical plane pressing on a bearing makes point contact, and then the rest is actually a little loose. Hydraulic nuts are better, but not as easy to work with. So, first thing I do is loosen up these 3 set screws that lock it in place and see if that made a difference. It did make a difference, but not enough. I backed off the set screws that locate this ring. That didn't make a difference. Now I know the helical plane of the nut is causing the problem. So what I want to do is mark my high spots. This one's for my indicator, which is a tense indicator. And then this one is the same high spot on the nut. What I have here is a spring punch. This one is a Spring Tools 5-piece Master Mechanic set. Looks like that. One of the trickiest little tools I've seen in a long time. This is made by Noxon. And they're in Spokane, Washington. I really just use the one that goes over here. What I like about it, it's got a nice flat spot. I could spring load and punch. I'm not doing a lot of damage to my bearing, and I'm just taking out the stress in this nut. So I would stress relieve at where the lock nuts are and then where my high point is. So I've already started on this one, and I've got it down to 4/10. My high spot is still in the same place, but I'm still 4/10. Okay. So I get it over here where I can see it. And I'm a little out of kilter. I would normally be doing it facing you, but I'm trying to get a video of it, right? So that's it. Go to my high spot, shift it a little bit from my red spot. Okay, so I'm still 4/10. So that tells me it's not so much this way as it's going to be the down way. So I'm going to sit right on there where I'm taking the stress out of the thread contact. Just like we lap something. Two and a half tenths. Two tenths. Now you see I've moved a little bit. That's that inclined plane. Three and a half. Where's my red spot? I'm 180 degrees from my red spot now. There you go. I bumped this indicator a little bit, so don't be too concerned if it's in a different area there. Big move, 5. And I'm back to my red spot. Almost get a full 1/10, more like half. But you see how quickly that makes a difference And it's just the stress is built up in that nut on the threads. Now I'm going to go ahead and tighten up those set screws. I'll do one at a time. I actually number them so I can keep track. I'm getting old and that's where it is. But I'll number those, I'll tighten them up, make sure my stress is down in there on that runout. It's super critical, especially something going 12 to 20,000 RPM all the time. The Matsuuras have another thing where the gear has to run out here really close. That takes a special indicator. So be sure you're watching out for those things. But in general use on the spindles, that's what I'm doing to get the run out down perfectly. Hard one to explain on the phone, so there it is. Hope that helps and get you all dialed in. I'm Bill Murphy with CNN Precision Spindle. Thanks for watching.